The Christmas message is coming from Pastor Roger Asselin. Let's give him a prayer. Come on. Give him some encouragement. Amen. Yes.
Thank you, sister. Amen. How many are happy to be here this afternoon? Glory to God. I don't know about you, but I've already been blessed today just by being here in everybody's presence and seeing all of the smiling faces, the wonderful children actually behaving themselves. That's because they haven't got a sugar high yet from all of the cookies and everything that are up there on that back table. Amen. Y'all, everybody here has already preached a Christmas message. It's not leaving me anything to say. But somebody shout Jesus.
Jesus.
Oh, come on. Jesus.
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 Christ.
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 Christ. Let's put Christ back in Christmas. Amen. Hey, Christ is the glue that holds us all together. Christ is the glue, hallelujah, that brings family together. Christ is the glue that he is the one. Christ is a definition of Jesus. Christ means deliverer. Christ means healer. Christ means savior. Look it up. Look the definition up. That's what that word means. It's a definition of Jesus, the Christ. Amen. Listen. Look at all these good things that are up here. And we've all heard the message that this is really not the reason for Christmas. But get this. If we didn't have Christ in our life, we wouldn't be here to be able to do this. Isn't that right? So what exactly did Jesus come to do? And I'm going to be short with this. I'm going to read you a scripture out of the book of St. Luke. And you'll find this in the book of Isaiah. But Jesus said when he first started his ministry, when I get this, he was born a baby in a manger. He grew up for about 30 years before he came into ministry. Amen? And he did the same thing all little kids did. He filled diapers. Come on now. Was he not a baby?
Yes.
And the Bible says he grew in stature. And he grew and he grew, but the Father had a plan for him. And when Jesus came to full into his ministry, after being in a desert and being tempted by the devil, this is what he said. He said these words. He says, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He hath sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives and recovering of the sight to the blind, and to set at liberty to them that are bruised." That's what he came to do. And that's the real purpose of Christmas. Amen. To bring a path back to the Father, amen, for man that has sinned throughout the years. Anybody here perfect? Thank you, Jesus. I thought I was the only one. Now, nobody here is perfect. And that's one of the reasons why we need Jesus. Amen. Listen, in just a few minutes, we're going to be giving out a whole bunch of stuff, right? Amen. But what is more important? The things that I just talked about. If somebody is here this afternoon that needs something more from Jesus than what you see up here and all around me, anybody need a little bit more? Just raise your hands right quickly. Everybody needs a little bit more. Wow, we're going to have an altar call, Sister Denise. Amen. Look at all these people that need a little bit more. Amen. I don't know about you, but I want a whole lot more. You're looking at an imperfect person. You're looking at an imperfect preacher. You're looking at an imperfect man, just like the rest of you are. We're all in the same boat. And we're here today not only to receive gifts and give gifts to one another, amen, but also we're here, let's pray for one another while we're here. Do you think that'd be a good idea to pray for one another? Do you think, Sister Denise, that'd be a good idea to have that, to pray for one another today? So here's what I'd like to do, and this is part of the Christmas message. You know, it's good to have faith, but faith without what is what? Faith without works is dead. You can say, "I have a relationship with Jesus Christ," but if you're not working, you got nothing.
Right.
Amen? To receive anything from Jesus, you must believe that what? That he is, and that he is a rewarder. Say, Jesus is a rewarder. He gives rewards, and it's more than this stuff up here. Some of you are going to be throwing this in the trash in a few months. Some of you are going to be having, mothers are going to be having a yard sale. So I got to get rid of some of this stuff. Amen. How many know what I'm talking about? But Jesus and the works that he does is forever and forever and ever. You must believe that he is and that he is the rewarder of those that what diligently seek him. So this afternoon, before we go any further, we're going to have a diligently seek him party. How about that? I didn't plan this. Hey, hallelujah. God knows what he's doing and the spirit is strong today. I'd like to start off with the children this afternoon. You know, why don't we do this? I know this is unusual for something like this. Let's have all of the children come up front here for a minute. All of the children come up front here just for a minute. Come on, kids. Come on, kids. Let's make this fast. Otherwise, you're going to be here for 2 hours and listen to me preach. Come on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All the kids. All the little kids, come on up. Big kids. Anybody that thinks they're going to get something off of this stage, come on up. All right. I want some prayer warriors up here, Sister Denise, Marge, and our hostess, and evangelist, and Mark. Marques, where is he at? He's not here yet. Amen. If there are any ministers here, I want to invite you to come up. I want you to come up. Hallelujah. Amen. Come on, Sister Denise, you're part of this. Come on up here. You're a big part of this. Now listen to me, children. This is very important. All of the stuff you see up here is the result of Jesus dying on that cross for you. Think about this. This is part of the many blessings that God has given us. And guess what? You, children, are the most important thing that we, the parents of the children, have here today. Your future is going to depend a lot upon what this world is going to be in the near future. Now, I want to, all you prayer warriors, anybody here, any of the kids here have a special need. If somebody has a real special need, before we pray for everybody else, I want you to raise your hand. I need something from Jesus.
Amen.
You come up here. You come up here. And anybody else have a special? Come on up here. Come on up here. Come on. Anybody have a special need, a very special need? Maybe you're being bullied. Come on, sweetheart. Maybe you're being bullied at school. Maybe you're sick in your body. Maybe you need, come on up here, son. Amen. Maybe you need a special thing in your life. You want something? Come on up, sweetheart. Don't be bashful. Amen. Anybody else this morning? Jesus. Jesus. Come on, prayer warriors. Put your hands on these kids. Anybody else? Don't be bashful. Go ahead up there, son. Now, what I want you to do, I want you to say, Jesus, in your heart, I don't want you to say anything out loud, okay? Whatever it's in your heart that you need, you speak to Jesus right now, okay? Close your eyes, raise your hand. That means you're surrendering to Jesus. Raise your hand towards the sky, towards Jesus. And don't say it out loud, but you're going to say, Jesus, I need. And whatever it is in your heart, you whisper it to him, okay? We're going to do that. Praise the Lord. Okay, you got that down? Jesus, right now, in your precious name, you come to heal. You come to forgive. You come to set free. Lord, I ask you right now, Lord, everybody that's up here that has this very special need, Lord, they had the nerve to come up. You're special. You're very special. You're very special in the name of Jesus. Lord, the needs of these young ones up here right now, Lord, I pray that every confession that they've made before you that needs to be taken care of, Lord God, that need be met right now in the precious name of Jesus. Heal, set free, cleanse, Lord God. Keep the devourer from each and every one of them, I pray, right now in the name of Jesus. Lord, do you work, and we give you glory and praise for it right now. Amen. Now, prayer warriors, get behind those that are out there. All you prayer warriors, get out there. You kids, stay right where you're at. Parents, come on up. I want all the parents to come up. Stand behind your kids. Okay, children, you go ahead back out there, okay? We're going to make a little bit more room. Thank you so much for coming. God's going to give you a special blessing, I promise you. Amen. You face me. You turn around and face me. We want the parents to come up. Okay, parents. Perhaps some of you here this afternoon, perhaps some of you here this afternoon are not where you should be with the Lord for whatever reason. I don't want anybody telling me what their problem is. You tell it to Jesus Christ. You follow me? Amen. So here's the thing. How many here, if you parents are have a special need today? You have a special need. Just raise your hands. Down there. Okay, here. Anybody else? You have a special need today, parents. Parents. We'll start with you, sister. Hallelujah. Lord, you know her heart. You know her heart. You know her needs right now. Lord God, whatever they might be, Jesus, let your Holy Ghost power come upon her right now, Lord. Just take that, fill that need right now in the precious name of Jesus. Lord, we come against all of the powers of darkness, Lord God. We plead your precious blood upon her life right now, whatever it might be. In Jesus' precious name, those of you that raised your hands today, if you're into drugs, you're into alcohol, or any kind of addiction, I pray that Jesus will deliver you from it right now, that you'll never pick up another thing that's going to harm your body and harm your family. In the name of Jesus, he's able to deliver immediately as I speak. You all been listening to the messages from the singers and from the actors and those are doing the dancing. It's all been the same message. I heard it over and over again. Jesus can do anything he wants to do. If you believe that, give him a big old hand clap of praise and believe him to do it in our lives, not only the children, but in your life as a parent as well. Hallelujah. That your children, your life hinges upon what you do with it today. God is a God that heals. God is the God that forgives. God is the God that loves. There's nothing that any of you have done here today, anything whatsoever, any evil thing that God will forgive you. And you got to let go of your past. When he tells you you've been forgiven, let go of your past. As you cannot leave here with guilt and condemnation and said you've had faith in the Lord Jesus Christ to deliver you from it. It takes that faith and belief in him, in Jesus Christ, a relationship with him. Have faith in your heart. You can say to this mountain, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea, and it will happen. Whatever your mountain is today that needs to be moved, believe it to be moved. Amen. He can do it. And have faith for it in Jesus' name. He will do it. He will do it in Jesus' name. Lord, bless each and every person that's come up for prayer. And Lord, those that have not, Lord, and they have a need in their life, I ask for your love, for your mercy. You just flow right now out to them. Bless them in your precious name, I pray. And everybody says,
amen.
Amen. You may be seated. Thank you so much. You see, Christmas, that's what Christ came for. That's exactly what Christ came for, sister. And listen, when you take his love and allow it into your life like you just did, when the devil comes against you, remember this day of prayer. And when he comes back and tries to get into your life again, do the same thing. Join hands with your family members. Love and forgive and bring back together. In Jesus' name, thank you, brother. Appreciate you.
Amen. Amen. Amen.